As a ARIPO, since 2008, we are organizing jointly with the WIPO Academy and the Africa University, which is based in Mutare in Zimbabwe, this master program on intellectual property. This program, once again, had a great impact in the continent, the whole continent. In 9 editions, we have trained more than 247 people who are now graduated as a master degree program on intellectual property. Now, these 247 people, we just conducted a tracer study, and we discovered that almost all of them, they are active in the area of intellectual property. Some are now in the intellectual property office, working there as examiners, officers, and some of them, they became the heads of the IP office due to this program. Some are patent agents, trademark attorneys, some other are in the courts. Some courts, we had the case of the commercial court in Ghana, for example, that directly requested us to train their judges. And after training those judges with the course, they created a section on intellectual property in the commercial court in Ghana. And this is happening in many other countries. So these people that were trained by the WIPO Academy in collaboration with ARIPO and the Africa University are changing the landscape of IP in the continent. They are not coming from the ARIPO member states only, but they come from more than 25 countries in the African continent. So this is a program that is open to anyone in the continent to attend. We have even people, candidates, who are from other countries outside Africa who are interested in the program. But because of the limitations that we have in terms of funding, we cannot take them, and we have limited ourselves in training people from Africa. Every year we receive more than 100 applications for this program, but we only have the capacity to receive 30 to 40 students. That means that more than 60 people every year fail to have the opportunity to be trained. And that shows that we need to come out with the other solutions in terms of offering this program to more people, because they're interested and they want to work in this area. The MIP program in Mutare in Zimbabwe indeed is a success story once again, because from this program really we've been able to capacitate, create those skills that the continent is in need. It's one of the platforms that really allows African people today to dialogue, to discuss about the intellectual property issues. We have just established a journal. It's called African Journal on Intellectual Property. We are now in a second issue. The first one was launched last year. And this is again the platform that we are providing to our master program student and any other academic people who want to write articles that are focusing on intellectual property in Africa. We believe that will be again another platform, intellectual platform, academic platform, that will allow us to mainstream, discuss issues related to the continent. We would like to see these initiatives growing and having more and more of these opportunities. So we have been in touch with some universities whom we would be interested in establishing master's degree program on intellectual property. We know that there are limitations. The WIPO Academy cannot be everywhere in the world, but I think we need to be creative in coming out with other initiatives. We cannot every year leave out more than 60 people who would like to learn about intellectual property. And we are interested in having people who are educated about intellectual property, and they are out there and they cannot access this opportunity. So once again, this is something that is open to debate, and how do we reach out those people who would like to learn more about intellectual property. We believe that more will come, more can happen in terms of the development of IP, but I think the basic ingredient for the development of IP in the African continent is education about IP. It's creating awareness, it's involving more and more universities and the research institutions in intellectual property.